Hello one and all, and welcome back to No Man's Sky with me, EkkiThump. Last session we completed our exploration of the fellowship system, and this time we are on our way to New Horizons. We are going to Estrovomamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamam opportunity to name our finds there. Here we go. Oh, hello. What have we got here? I've never seen that before. It's the space anomaly. Let's go and check it out. Okay, please don't be something that kills me. Please do not be something that kills me. I guess this is where we go in. I guess right. Wow, okay. So first stop in this system. This seems Atlas related, I'd guess. Holy fuck, what are you? Oh, it's a Korvax dude. And a Gek. Oh, it's Rala and Polo. No, Nada and Polo. Rare linguistic form. Pleasure. Nada. Divergent Korvax. Assistance offered. Route to Galactic Core. Reconnect with Atlas for guidance. Resources for journey. Yes, no. As I approach the electronic being, it springs to life. From its dark mask, scanning beams emerge that envelop me. There is an unnerving chittering sound, and then unbelievably, it speaks in my language. It offers me a choice. It can show me how to harness black holes in order to embark upon a journey to the centre of the galaxy. It can light my way to an Atlas interface, which I already have, so I may follow a path. Or it will assist me in my own exploration. So you want resources? Find a shortcut to the centre. Resume the path of the Atlas. Well, if we resume the path of the Atlas, I mean, that just takes us the way we're already going. Let's have a look at some black hole action. The alien locates a black hole. Yeah, that's great, but how do I use them? It's a sweet cape, man. This guy's dressed really fancy. What about you, Polo? Friends everywhere, if only you know where to look. Friends in all shapes, all sizes, all places. The shorter entity, Gek, has a jocular air about them. They idly wipe grease-splattered hands on their suit as they address me. Some sort of engineer, maybe. To my surprise, they speak my language. Other life forms have treated me with amused indifference, but Polo treats me like an equal. They are curious about my travels, about what sentient species I have seen. If I have met life forms, they have not. They hope that I will share my experiences. Yeah? Polo pores over the data, muttering bitterly at beings they're already familiar with, cheering at those they are not. Oh, wow. So, oh, we've got the Atlas Pass version 1 formula. Iron and Heridium, easy. So it is actually an item that we need to craft. What's this thing? So that was Polo and the other one. Shit, I keep forgetting his name. Rada and Polo? Nada and Polo? I can't even speak to him anymore. Something and Polo. Hey, hey you. No? Okay. Well, there we go. So we've got a V1 Atlas Pass, which will let us get a bit more bang for our buck as we're exploring. I don't need to go to the space station straight away, but we may as well swing by there and see what kind of system we're in. So does this allow us access to here, or do we have to get the version 2 one? All of these space stations we go into, there's a second door. I'm not sure if it requires a version 1 or a version 2 Atlas Pass. Fantastic. And we get to keep the pass as well. You only have to make it once. That's brilliant. Oh, look at this. This is the members only section. Oh, we're in a Vy'keen system as well. We know a bunch of their language already. I mean, unfortunately, all of this crap here we already have. But exosuit upgrade. And there's one of those in every space station, so from now on, every time we jump to a new system... Oh, it's a V3 pass. Every time we jump to a new system, we can get a free... Well, not free, but a guaranteed extra slot up to the maximum. Alright, let's go and say hello to the... I'm guessing it's going to be a Vy'keen, the manager of the station. Right, mate. Rah, Vy'keen Ogs Badagunkpi. Haj Hibamuo. Death. Alright, Nias Saxanfu. Gaku Luhun Unquin. Isotope. The warrior is building a nuclear warhead. The plan it holds in its hand are unmistakable. A complicated sequence of technology blueprints and isotopic chemical reactions is waiting for the final addition of an element to be complete. There are countless lives on an unknown planet far out in the cosmos that could one day end due to this life form's work. Okay, we're going to tell the Gek, and I receive a roar from a distant species. Jetpack booster. What about this door over here? That's a V3 door as well. And I assume that one's a V3 as well. Shit, man. It's like in... I don't know if you've ever seen that film. Well, read the book anyway. How to Lose Friends and Alienate People. Because there's a bit in that where, like, the Hollywood, like, cognoscenti sort of guy... who's the main character's mentor slash antagonist, gives him a speech about how, like, there are 7 rooms of fame and the main character is only in the first room and he has to find his way to the second room. That's kind of us, you know. We're past the velvet rope, but we're still, you know, we're stuck in the lobby with all the Hollywood plebs who are like trying to break out of acting in soap operas and stuff. We still need to find the pass that lets us get into the back room with Tom Cruise. So here we are on a cold planet. I want to go down. I actually want to explore this planet. Let's see what we're dealing with here. Come on, there's plenty of room to land. Sentinels are hostile. Pink dirt. So in terms of recipes, what we're looking for at the moment is iridium, because I want to build the upgraded warp reactor. Where's that column of red shit that I was trying to land next to? I want to see what resources we've got on the planet. Looks like there's no hazard on this planet, or if there is, it's been soaked up at the moment by one of our shields. Oh, hello, what are these? Oh, Gravitino balls. I don't think we need any of those at the moment. Scanned a bird. Ah, it's over there. Lots of birds on this planet. It's hard to tell what this is. I think it's just... Are you fucking kidding me? Aluminium again. There's an entire goddamn universe of aluminium in this game. And the thing is, it's always... Because aluminium is like white and reflective, it always looks like it's going to be something interesting. Because it reflects the colour of the sky and the land instead of being like... Like emerald or gold, it's not a proper colour of its own. It's deceptive. Aluminium deposits and aluminium crystals. I'd be excited about the Gravitino balls, but we've already got what we need out of those. Oh, okay. We're starting off with a nice plaque at least. Ancient knowledge passed down through generations of Vy'keen warriors spills from the marker stone, filtering into my mind like a long forgotten memory. Grah! The Sentinels are the enemy of progress and civilization. They are not of the natural order. Their interference is an affront to the virtuous Vy'keen crusade, which seeks to balance in all things through blood, ashes, and iron. This affront to the Vy'keen and their creed cannot go unpunished. It's good to be back, isn't it? Well, I don't think we can actually take off until we find some more plutonium, so let's go and have a wander. Ah, it's cold. It's a cold planet. Not desperately cold. Possibly only because we were actually underwater is the only reason it was showing us cold. Oh, holy shit, we did actually need one of those stones for something. Come on, show me plutonium. Nothing. There's a Gravitino ball there. Let's swim over to the mainland. See if we can find some over there. Oh, it's a T-Rex! And it's fucking angry. Well, it didn't last long, did it? Pretty cool gun. What? Extreme conditions? Call this extreme, it's only minus 50. God, we were on a planet with minus 100 before. Extreme conditions. Wow, what the fuck? There's another shoe-headed thing over there. But... Are you mad? Yep. Y'all ain't got shit. Is there still a sentinel around? Oh, check this out. We can open this debris now. Hostiles approaching. Warning. Sentinel drones activated. After I recharge the gun, because apparently we're going to be doing a lot of fighting this episode. Technology recharge. So yeah, this Atlas Pass container. It's ours. Suspension fluid. Antimatter. Hostiles approaching. Warning. Sentinel drones activated. Fuck you guys. Alright, let's go back to the ship. Actually, I can't. Oh, actually, I haven't got any slots left. We need to transfer some shit to the ship. Sorry about that, old chap. Some kind of base? Very small one. You fucking guys. All I want to do is craft these thingamajigs I got. Suspension fluid makes antimatter. Wait a minute, it says antimatter and suspension fluid. Thorium 9 and antimatter. Wait. Oh, okay, I need to get the plutonium and thorium. What have we got here? So these V1 containers, it looks like they always give us fucking sentinels. Looks like they always give us warp cell like fuel. May as well just kill sentinels on sight, because they're gonna alert to us on this planet no matter what we do. Yeah, but I've got... Oh no, I haven't actually got space there. Will you fuck off, Jesus? Activate. Okay, so we yeah. Need to make a bypass chip if we can. Send me to a monolith. An underwater plaque, that'll do. Okay, so we need to get some thorium so we can turn this suspension fluid into antimatter. No wait, so we can turn suspension fluid into electron vapor. Okay, so that's electron vapor. We make that into antimatter. With a bit more iridium, zinc, and then we turn those into warp cells using a bit of thorium. Where's a good spot to land to get to that? Probably on this little island here if we can. There we go. Super pro. Ooh, what's this? Ah, iridium. We actually needed some of that. Where is it? Yeah, we'll get a bit of carbon. Oh bollocks, I only produced one though. Okay, you know what? We don't need this much titanium. Right. So we need to craft one more antimatter. Oh god, now we've got no zinc. It's probably in the ship, isn't it? Well, anyway, we can do that when we get back. Runes take shape upon the stone, burning with light. They sing to me of the Vy'keen ancients in the language of my people. Before the coming of Herc, the Vy'keen feared the Sentinels. Like all races, our people cowered from their unquestioning violence, shrank from their tyrannical rule. But the coming of Herc heralded a new dawn. Through their leader, the Vy'keen became strong. Now their courage knows no bounds. Why is my... I've just fucking charged that. Ooh, fish. Okay, right. So we should be able to make another antimatter now. We have no thorium on the ship. Oh, I guess we put it all in the pulse engine, haven't we? Okay, well, not a problem. Let's proceed. Oh, I wonder if that reaches anything. Let me land here. Well, it's almost so. It is. It's iridium. Okay. Let's get some of this. Thank God for that. We found a planet with two resources. Ah, and some thorium flowers. Well, we've got loads of oxides which we can pump into the frost shield thing. Oh, look at this little guy. It would crack me up if that was hostile. God, I can't even lock onto him to scan him. Oh, there he goes. So, I need to find whatever it was that I was supposed to be investigating when I landed. It was probably over there, wasn't it? Have we scanned that? No. We may have enough to... We do have enough to make a warp cell now. Okay. Strange writings form upon the stone, revealing secrets from the time of the Vy'keen ancients. How I understand them, I do not know. Herc looked to the skies and witnessed the pitiless destruction of the sentinels that smothered all races brought forth out unto the outer edge. Worlds withered and died beneath their relentless gaze. The anger of Herc was unleashed. Okay. I can't remember which way I needed to go for the other nearby thingamajigs. So let's just get back in the ship and we'll do another scan from the air. So we can refuel. Okay, pretty much full there. And oh, we can put this warp cell in the hyperdrive. And let's piss off before those drones get any ideas. The whispers of the Vy'keen ancients fill the air. Suddenly words etched themselves upon the marker and then deep into my mind. And so it came to pass that on the eve of the 18th moon of Drungala, Herc cast the shackles of the sentinel oppressors into the pit. The Vy'keen were the glorious first, the rising water that broke the dam. The endless war began. Leave. Something I never noticed before. You get, as well as the animals, you get little pings on the scanner. I'm not sure what they're actually pointing to. Huh? Yeah, you get, like, see there, like, little white dots. What are they pointing to? Are they pointing to, sentinels? Hostiles approaching. Warning. Oh, that one over there. See, behind the rock. Or on the rock. I'm not sure what they mean. Maybe we could pick a different planet to explore on, though. So if we linger here too long, we're just going to get sentinels all over us. Aha! And even before that, we've got something hidden away in this little nook here. How is the... Okay, we need, I think, about another 120 thormium. Surprise! Can I actually... Oh, we can craft a bypass chip. Okay, well, we've seen a ton of plaques this session. Let's finish off by trying to visit an actual colonial outpost. Oh, a manufacturing facility. That's nice. That'll give us a recipe, hopefully. See what's in this place first. Blueprint for the scanner. Don't you literally start the game with that? Fuck you. Jeez, chaps, at least give me some challenge. We triggered this? No, we haven't. Okay, so I believe we have to blow the doors off to get into these places. So let's blow the bloody doors off. Grenades are supposed to be good with this, but I just want to try the mining beam one time. Excellent. Oh, there's a sentinel inside. It's okay, you can't shoot me. This is weird. Get the fuck out, what are you doing in here? This isn't your manufacturing facility, but no, because I'm inside, you see. And the rules say that if I'm inside, it's legal. So I'm going to go here and restore shield. You guys can't do anything. I'm going to go over here. I'm going to trigger this fucking encyclopedia. And I'm going to scan this multi-tool tech, which gives me someone I already know. And I'm going to whip out my gun, and I'm going to reload my gun right in front of you. And you lot can't do anything about it. I thought I'd sold that ball. Okay, so a laser scan refracts through my visor, and then another traces the air around my breathing exhaust. My gas concentration levels don't match the warrior standard. Intruder Antonquin, Minsazumli gas high, enemy blah 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 blah. So this could be telling me the gas is too high. So something like intruder alert, exhaled gas too high, enemy infiltration. I'm going to go ahead and say we want to decrease it. I feel nauseous and nothing happens. Shit. Can we have another go? No, we can't. Damn, I was being too clever. Oh well. That'll do us for this episode. What I'm actually going to do is hop into this ship and take off into space, because I don't want to get attacked by sentinels while I'm sitting here trying to name the planet. So let's take off. Aim our nose into the sky. So first off, we want to rename the system. I've been playing a fair bit of Path of Exile recently, so we're just going to call it Erayclast. And I guess the first planet might as well be Lion-Eye's Watch. So there we go, we're going to upload that and that, and we're going to upload a bunch of animals, get a ton of cash. So that's pretty much it for this episode. I'm going to go and get some thormium and install the expanded warp drive, and oh yes, and finish crafting the warp cells with the stuff we found. So, pretty exciting episode. We've got ourselves an Atlas Pass. The first of three, I believe. Don't know how you get the other two, but I'm sure we'll find out. Anyway, for now, this has been Let's Play No Man's Sky, and I've been EkkiThump. Hope you've enjoyed it. Like and subscribe if you'd like to see more gameplay of this game, and I will see you next time.